What's good, world? You are back with another great episode of What the Biz is going on in the world today. And yes, I had to do another episode of Justhenobodys. Why my first one did pretty good, you know, it got like 100 views, you know, but it's really dope to see the theories that comes out about these Disney stories and Pixar and all these animations, the movies that us as grown-ups, we may not be seeing. But I'm a big, you know, cartoon addict. I love watching great cartoons or great animation movies with, you know, a lot of meaning. And sometimes I might not know what the thought of the process or the thought of what came about to this film or how all these films connected. So Justhenobodys really came in and really kind of start coming with these theories of what Disney's about and these stories. So what I wanted to do was I just wanted to play a clip of them speaking on it, and let's see what happens. Let's see if you're shocked just as much as I am.
Have you heard of the Frozen theory?
Which one?
This is a good one. So I read this article, and remember at the beginning of the film, we see Elsa and Anna's parents going on a boat for a voyage?
Right.
But what people don't know is that Elsa and Anna's mom's actually pregnant, and at some point at sea, she has a baby boy.
What?
Remember how we see Elsa and Anna's parents' boat like in a huge sea storm, and it causes their boat to sink?
Yeah.
So this is where the theory comes in. There's a theory that the baby boy they have at sea is actually Tarzan.
Wait, what?
And that they use the rescue rowboat to get to a nearby jungle.
Wait, I thought they died, though.
That's what people think. But when you look at a map, Scandinavia, where Elsa and Anna's from, is right above Africa. So probably after the storm, the closest place to go was the African jungle.
What?
And what makes this theory even crazier is that the director of the film, Jennifer Lee, confirmed that Tarzan is Elsa and Anna's long-lost brother.
No.
So it's not a theory, it's actually a fact.
Wait, that actually makes both movies a lot better, though.
It really does. Have you heard of the Frozen theory?
You gotta be kidding me. That's crazy how this is like kind of comes out like a real life. It's weird. This is crazy. Are you serious? Wow. Amazing. Amazing. Wow.
Lilo and Stitch theory?
No.
So we know that Lilo and Nani's parents passed away from a car accident, right?
Right.
So you ever wonder why Mr. Bubbles, the social worker, is always checking on Lilo and Nani?
Why?
Okay, so I read this article, and the theory is that Lilo and Nani's parents were actually CIA agents that worked with Mr. Bubbles. And before they died, they instructed him that if anything happens to them, he has to take care of Lilo and Nani.
Oh my gosh.
Right? Okay. And at the end of the movie, Mr. Bubbles even tells Nani that he was a CIA agent that used to work with aliens.
Right, I remember that.
Right, which is why the Grand Councilwoman recognized him. And don't you think it's kind of weird? He went from CIA agent to someone who takes care of kids that have no parents.
Especially how he became a social worker right after Lilo and Nani's parents passed away.
Exactly.
Wow. Oh my gosh, that makes so much sense.
Have you ever heard of the...
I didn't know that. I didn't know the depths of that. I just thought Stitch was like a cool animal to have. Like, if I can have a little alien animal, that'd be dope. But, I mean, I didn't know that. That's really huge. Golly. Wow.
No. So we all know the show's about Timmy.
Have you ever heard of the Lilo and...
Have you ever heard of the Fairly Odd Parents theory?
No.
So we all know the show's about Timmy Turner's fairy godparents and how his parents don't care about him and his babysitter's always messing with him.
Right.
I saw a video by WatchMojo, and this is where the theory comes in. There's a theory that Cosmo and Wanda aren't actually there.
What?
And actually, Timmy's going through depression and needs medication, so Cosmo and Wanda are actually his antidepressant medication.
Oh my gosh.
So Cosmo represents a medication called Prozac, and Wanda represents a medication called Zoloft.
Wait, isn't Prozac a green pill?
Yeah, it's an antidepressant. You know what else is super crazy? The only time you see Cosmo and Wanda in this show is when Timmy's in trouble and needs help.
Yeah.
Because that's when Timmy's having anxiety and needs his antidepressants.
Wait, that makes so much sense.
And just like medication, when you use over the suggested amount, things go wrong for your body and it could be really bad.
Right.
And that's why whenever Cosmo and Wanda use too much of their powers to help Timmy, things go wrong and the show gets out of control.
Wait, now that I think about it, Cosmo and Wanda are always like, are you sure you want to do this to me? It might be dangerous.
We're trying to warn him not to use too much of our powers because it could go wrong for you. But they have to do it anyways because he's taking it.
Oh my gosh, how did I never see that?
I know, it's crazy. Have you ever heard of...
That's nuts. I just thought they were actually two fairly godparents that just popped up out the blue. That makes sense. I mean, like, wow. Because a lot of kids are dealing with depression, and that would make sense for them to... Because I took pills and stuff when I was younger, and it didn't feel like a fairly godparent that was popping up out the blue. But... You know, I mean, I had to take it because I was so hyper. I was just jumping off the wall everywhere. You know what I mean? I was just so hyper. But I get it. Like, I said, wow, that's nuts. That's nuts. Wow. Wow. That's nuts.
Why? So I read this fandom post by SpongeBob Lover04, right?
With that name, it better be a good theory.
Yeah, so the theory is that the chum bucket runs on cannibalism.
What?
Like, do you know what chum is?
It's like the bait they use to catch, like, sharks and stuff.
Right. Do you know how it's made?
No.
It's ground up fish.
What?
So the theory is that plankton secretly kills fish and grinds them up and puts it in his burger.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. Right, that's why no one likes it, because they're eating themselves.
Yeah, no one's ever in his restaurant. It's always just him and his robot.
That makes sense. Cannibalism.
It's worse than McDonald's.
Oh, my God. You know why no one likes the chum bucket in SpongeBob?
Why?
So I...
That makes sense. Dude, are they doing that at McDonald's? Wow. Next. Can't do it.
Fine. Oh boy, let's hear it. In 2015 in Danbury, Connecticut, there was a teenage girl named Rebecca Townsend. And Rebecca's goal in life was to complete her bucket list.
Wow.
She actually wrote herself a letter of all the things she wanted to do before she died. On that list, there was like...
So, I know you wonder, why is he showing this? This has nothing to... This was like a bonus. Justhenobodys had did this, and I thought this was like, wow. I thought this was like kind of crazy. Now, mind you, I am just now watching this for the first time. I have not seen this at all. You know, you might say cap, but let me take off my cap to let you know it ain't no cap. I'm not capping. I'm serious. I have not seen it. I'm shocked. Like, I'm watching this for the first time. Like, that's the way to really see a good video, to get a real good recap on what's going on in our world. So this is, like, really a What the Biz moment. But this is a bonus. Let's check out what they have. What's his story.
It was like, take a trip to Spain. Have a kiss in the rain, like in the movies.
Uh-huh.
The last thing on her list was to save a life before she died. And that was the only thing she hasn't done yet.
That's crazy.
So one day, her and her friend were walking on the street. And as she was crossing the street, unfortunately, she got hit by a car and died.
No.
She managed to complete her bucket list.
Are you serious?
Seconds before getting hit by a car, she managed to push her friend out of the way and in turn saving his life.
Oh, that gave me goosebumps.
I know, it's crazy. I have a crazy story that's gonna...
So, this chick had a bucket list, as I'm consuming right now. The chick had a bucket list, and on her bucket list was one that was to save her life. And it actually came to pass. See, people, it actually came to act. See, people, you have to be careful what you put on your bucket list. Like, it's okay if you want to be in, you know, on your bucket list, you want to be in a Barney suit, barbecuing with the homies or something. That makes perfectly sense. It's crazy. It's like, what the? But that makes perfect sense. Nobody's at harm. No, life is still continuing. But that's nuts to put something on your bucket list as, you, yes, you could save a life. You could become a doctor. Why not become a doctor? I think what it is when we put words out, it comes to life. And we have to be careful of what we say. So in a good book, it says, the tongue is a double-edged sword. So you better watch out. Yikes, that's our episode, people. I am going to like really like give you guys, wow, that was shocking. I'm kind of stuck right now. Give me a moment. Wow. So, yikes. People, tune in next time to the next video I will be putting out. Thank you to the Justhenobodys. This video is credited to them. You know, you guys go follow them on TikTok or Facebook. Also, they have a podcast on YouTube. But I love their theories. I just love how they come up with these crazy, you know, I mean, stories. Or some of these, like the story we just read right now, is actually true. So, you know, this is really a What the Biz moment. Check it out next time. Thank you guys for tuning in. Really appreciate y'all. I'm out. See y'all.